made a few changes behind the scenes of this video. Please let me know in the comments below if anything seems odd or doesn't work. Thank you so much, and onwards to the video. Thank you for joining us as we help Theo create his new Promethean character using his Chronicles of Darkness character, Polonius Dewberry. Hedgehogs need to be kept warm, so Theo's going to go in here for a bit during the entire portion of this, and we'll see if he comes out. First up, we've been doing character creation spanning all the game lines for quite a while now. I've covered mage, vampire and werewolf, and we got changeling, demon, deviant, mummy, and all the other ones coming up next. Right now though, we have Prometheus. Prometheus is a fun one because it's taking Frankenstein and turning it on its head into something more akin to Pinocchio. Unlike other splats like vampires and werewolves, Prometheans aren't human to begin with. They start out as Frankensteins and turn into humans later, similar to how Pinocchio wants to become a real boy. They start with 3 dots of merits, just like all the other supernatural creatures. They have a lineage, which is the subtype of Promethean, sort of how they were created, and it gives them access to certain types of abilities. Then you pick your first refinement and a role within it. Usually there are 3 roles to 1 refinement, and by completing roles and refinements, you progress along your pilgrimage to become human. There is the Elpis, I hope I pronounced that right, which replaces your virtue. It is the trait that wants you to finish the pilgrimage to become human, whereas you also have a Torment, which replaces your vice, which keeps the Promethean distant from humanity. You get to select a bestowment, which is a special ability from your lineage. The base ones, they're only 2 per lineage, and you only get 1 of them. Then your Azoth starts at 1. Then you pick 2 transmutations and 1 alembic for each. Now, your pilgrimage starts at 1 dot, and as I said before, it represents you becoming human, and you have to answer 5 questions, which will help determine the milestones you need to progress through your pilgrimage. For Theo's Elpis, he has chosen love, which means if he witnesses an act of love, it will grant him more willpower, and if it causes a setback, it will grant him all of his willpower. Then he has Torment, which he chose Naive, which means if his lack of understanding causes a problem or a setback, he'll regain some willpower. Now his lineage is going to be Ulgon, which was chosen by our patron. It is a corpse that was torn apart and reassembled by spirits. The humor that animates it is ectoplasm, so the ectoplasm that animates ghosts. This grants him access to either the ephemeral flesh or twilight fluidity bestowments. He has chosen the ephemeral flesh bestowment because it allows him to spend 1 Pyros to perceive and interact with ghosts and spirits in Twilight. Pyros being the resource that Prometheans use to power up their ability. For Polonius's refinement, we have chosen the refinement Pin, which is also known as Stanum. This allows Polonius to take the Vigilante role, Vigilante role, and grants access to the Electrification and Quiet Disquietism transmutations, which are 2 of my favorite, which is why I picked one. The refinements also grant the refinement conditions, which can be used to get more XP. Polonius gets the enrage condition, which grants Pyros when he indulges into his torment. Additionally, he'll receive an extra beat per chapter if he suffers a setback for indulging in his anger or cruelty. Oh, are you angry, little guy? Over here, I'll probably show some abilities and conditions that you get for using some of these powers. So the first power we're going to cover is electrification. First thing you need to know is if you choose not to show your disfigurements when you're using the power, it causes the Degoss condition, which is over here. For one of the alembics that he has chosen the Arc Alembic as a persistent effect, which means it's always an effect. Polonius can create minor electrical effects that can burn through thin materials such as zip ties. Alembics are always active and persistent so long as the Promethean has access to it, so switching your roles and which transmutations you have will remove an alembic effect unless you spend XP to calcify it, which makes it permanent to use regardless of what role or refinement you're using. I'm just going to let Theo right here. This grants him access to the spark distillation, which allows him to shoot electricity from his hands, shock, which modifies spark to hit everything within a radius around him, and divine lightning, which upgrades spark to do damage over time to a target. And by spending extra pyros, it grants 3 aggravated base damage to a target with extra lethal as per successes rolled like usual. So you don't get extra aggravated damage from your successes with this ability. For Polonius's second ability, Theo has chosen Disquietism. Disquietism grants the irritable condition if Polonius does not use his disfigurements when he uses an alembic or an ability. He's chosen the Redirect Alembic, which gives him a persistent effect that means he can exceptionally succeed on 3 successes to impose the notoriety condition. Additionally, he has an ability called Scapegoat, which allows him to redirect the negative effects of disquiet he generates to another person. Disquiet is a condition I will go on further down the road, but essentially you need to know that humans around Prometheans get more irritable until they get essentially killy towards the Prometheans. They'll kill them by, like, hugging them to death if they're a little too affectionate in some cases, or they will just set them on fire like that. So he can make another person take that downside for him. There's additionally Rabid Rage, which causes animals to attack the scapegoat, and Iago's Whisper, which causes a person to attack the scapegoat directly. As for the 3 additional dots of merits, he's going to take the Brute Force merit at 1 dot, which grants him a +1 bonus to strength rolls while he's in torment, and he gets the 8 again if he uses 8 again quality if he uses the all out attack action on opponents, which removes his defense but gets +2 dice as well. And if it's a big attack, it causes a knockdown tilt. Additionally, he's chosen Sleepless, which means he doesn't suffer fatigue from not sleeping, and Acid Stomach, which means he can digest inorganic matter. Let's go over some of the pros for being a Promethean. We have Azoth Radiance, which means Prometheans can roll Wits plus Azoth to detect other sources of Azoth, such as other Prometheans. They can use Dampen the Fire, which allows them to reduce their Azoth quality so that people have a harder time finding them, such as Pandorans and hostile Prometheans. Then you have Transhuman Potential, which by spending some Pyros, you can boost some attributes by 1 dot Burnishin. You have Shock Absorption, which means you can spend Pyros to absorb damage at 1-for-1 for lethal damage, 1-for-2 for bashing, and 3-for-1 for aggravated. Now, you do have to have the Azoth level required for spending multiple Pyros in one turn, but that's about it for that. Alembics give you a persistent effect, which we've already covered before. You can replenish your Pyros via one of the following. The Sunrise gives you +1 Pyros. Witnessing a thunderstorm gives you 1. Sleeping near a key element grants you Pyros. Gaining 1 Pyros for being around humans for more than an hour. Healing damage from electricity regains Pyros. And some distillations also help you gain Pyros. There's Elphis Vision, which is an ability that allows you to essentially ask questions of the storyteller or game master what you need to do to finish your milestones for getting closer to the pilgrim. And additionally, you have durability, which means you do not suffer wound penalties or fall unconscious, and you can only die by aggravated damage. Journey to the River is once per game, per character, unless you're an Osiris with the proper bestowment, the Promethean can resurrect after being killed. Then you have Constitution, which means you can eat any organic matter, and hunger only happens after days equal to your resolve dots. You're unaging, which means you don't age until you become mortal, though they do die after a century, but they can be resurrected through their journey to the river if it hasn't been used yet. There's electroshock therapy, which means being exposed to electricity can allow a Promethean to heal and gain Pyros. Then there's creation, which means Prometheans can create other Prometheans. Then there's new dawn, which means a Promethean can eventually become human. There's a lot of complicated dice rolling that you have to do for it, but it's possible. And then there's the lacuna, which is you can steal vitriol from another Promethean, but it's considered very bad to do. And then there's Athanors, which is you can create an item marking or shrine as a supernatural item for other Prometheans to use. For cons, I actually wasn't able to find that many. There's Measure, which means Prometheans' torments are recorded on their Azoth, and other Prometheans can sense the presence of them on them. So the more torments you have had in the past, the more other Prometheans can see that on you. Then you have aggravated damage from something like fire. Anytime you take aggravated damage, it also gives you a tilt injury, a physical tilt injury. So this is your arms and limbs get lopped off very easily, and then you have to put them back on or get a replacement. Then you have your disfigurements, which are your true form, and it can cause disquiet in people that see you, specifically humans, but there are also other supernatural creatures that can get disquiet as well. The only ones that really aren't affected by it are mummies and demons. But for mummies, it's because they're very powerful, but if their cultists get affected, then they might be upset with you. And for demons, they can control the ability of getting affected by disquiet. I think beasts are also immune, but it's up to your GM, really. I never used disquiet on other supernaturals because it would make running a game with a Promethean very difficult to do. Other downsides include torment, which is a forced behavior that is inhuman and is determined by the Promethean's lineage. It is caused by knowingly causing stage 3 disquiet, taking aggravated damage from fire, recovering all your willpower from your torment trait, major failure related to the pilgrimage, or dramatic failures for certain distillations. Now, your torment only stops when the Promethean witnesses something related to the Elpis. So for Theo, Polonius, it means he needs to see an act of love in order to stop being aggravated or tormented. Now, the only other way to stop it is by creating a wasteland, changing your refinement, or being away from humanity for a month, which for a game that doesn't skip time very much might be a problem. Now, I mentioned disquiet, I mentioned wastelands. I'm going to put disquiet up here to show you, which is essentially a condition that gets imparted on people that makes them less likely to be socially convinced by Prometheans or talked to. So they'll be focused in specifically on certain types of actions. For Frankensteins, Prometheans will be looked at with anger. For Galantide, I think that's how you pronounce it, they'll be looked on with like love and admiration, to the point where someone will actually like love you so much that they're going to kill you so no one else can love you type thing. But there are other types for the different Promethean lineages. I'm not going to go into all of them. For wasteland, what a wasteland is, it is an area around where the Promethean was that essentially has a lot of Pyros infused in it. It's basically like chaos incarnate. They're very difficult to deal with, and some Prometheans can burn away the firestorm or cause a firestorm to get rid of a wasteland, but it's still kind of like a dangerous place for Prometheans and for normal people to be in. I'm not going to go into detail with it because it's its own system, but if you want me to go into detail on it, maybe I'll do a video in the future on it. Kind of winding down on some of these videos because not many people are interested in Promethean the Created or some of the smaller game lines. But if you want to know more about them, please let me know in the comments below and I'll try and get to them when I can. Thank you so much for watching, and Theo is happy that everyone's here. I'm happy everyone's here. Thank you so much for watching and have a good
shout out to our patrons for supporting the channel.